All right, friends. I don't know what day it is. 17? Something's happening to my skin. Day 17 of vegan cooking. And I am making a red curry again, but this time I'm doing a little bit of a different technique because I want to try something new. Check it out. Boom. In today's vegan curry, we have mushrooms. We have tofu, but the tofu is shredded. Because I read that if it has more surface area, it'll soak up the flavors better. I really hope so. I got onions, I got garlic, I got carrots. The last time I made this though, I had like zucchini and other vegetables. I have an orange bell pepper. But I did want to show you that I am shredding my tofu. I'm shredding the tofu. It literally kind of reminds me of like cheese, the way it shreds. Because I read that if it has more surface area, it soaks in the flavor better. I want to show you. Look at that. Isn't that crazy? But look at this. It looks like pulled chicken or like cheese. So I'm going to bake this in the oven while I have my red curry cooking, and I'm gonna bake this in the oven and season it with like taco seasoning because I'm gonna try to eat this like shredded chicken in my tacos. So I'm gonna bake this, put a little bit of oil on it with some seasonings and see how it turns out. Now the other stuff that is cooking in my pan is that red curry. Now, I have to admit, the last time I made the sauce versus me making the sauce this time, I don't know why they taste different. Now, it is totally cooking and seeping in there, so I hope that as it cooks, that I'll enjoy the flavor more. But, yeah, a secret ingredient I read online was to put some type of almond butter or peanut butter on there. So I did. I put some peanut butter on there. And I don't know if I put a ratio of more peanut butter this time. It just tastes different. I'll include in my comments or in the bio, in the description, look at that, what I put in this pan to make this red curry. One of the key ingredients is buying a red curry paste because it has a bulk of the flavor in there. Look at all of this. It really looks like shredded chicken, doesn't it? I've been experimenting. If you've been keeping up with the journey, yesterday I made fried mushrooms, kind of like remind me of like fried chicken, you know? And it was good. Very, very, very good. Very, very, very good. Today I'm actually gonna dip it in a sauce. Let me put my hair up. As I'm cooking, I don't like my hair in my face. How's everyone doing today? Today's been an interesting day for me, but it has felt very productive. Very unexpected, but very productive. Can anybody relate? One of the things, though, that I think the Lord has been teaching me that I'd love to share is trust. Trust that He's our defender. Trust that He's worthy to be trusted. Trust that He's a good, good Father. Just trusting God and who He says He is and what He's about, you know? And I think sometimes that's hard. It's hard to trust. But so what do we do to overcome the obstacle of trusting? I'm gonna put some oil at the bottom of this. I think for me, the best way to overcome the obstacles in the areas I don't trust in, my oven always does that, is to do it anyway. So do it scared and let God show up. And I think today was a day where, I'm wondering if I should season this before I stick it on here, or do I season the pan? in the season before. While I'm doing this, I should check on our curry. Because, honey, I'm tired of burning things. If you watched yesterday's video, I'm constantly burning things. Okay. Looks good. Ooh, good thing I'm mixing this. So let me tell you what's in there. I'm gonna lower the heat. Coconut milk. Yeah, let me lower that. She really bubbling, honey. Coconut milk, mushrooms, carrots, yellow, and orange pepper. Yeah, it's orange. As it cooks, it looks yellower. And shredded tofu. Something I think I would do differently, I would cook my tofu alone with some seasonings before I stuck it in here. Yeah, let's see. It's not bad, it just tastes like peanut sauce more than curry. I'm debating if I should, I'm gonna put more curry paste in there. See what happens. Ready? It smells so strong. I'm bringing it to you like you can smell it. The spices and curry paste involve lemongrass, salt, shallots, garlic, red chili pepper, lime peel. Oh, I forgot the lime. That is one thing that I put in last time. Like squeeze the lemon in here or lime. But I put a little more paste in here because I feel like it's tastes more peanut buttery than red. Than curry, red curry-esque. I also think I'm gonna add some red chili flakes. But you could use some heat. You could benefit from some heat. Hopefully that's not too much heat. Bam! It's starting to look more like curry. I'm definitely gonna grab a lemon. Or a lime. Some citrus might. Oh, here you are. Anyway, y'all, I wanna know your name. Is that what it is? I wanna know your plan, your name. What is it? What is the words? Need to get back to my shredded chicken. Wink, wink. My shredded tofu. Let's see. I'm shocked that significantly got better with those minor changes, yo. Wow, I'm gonna squeeze a little bit more lime juice. Why does this lime juice bring out? It brings out something so rich and fresh. Like, wow, wow, wow. When I first started, I was like, I'm gonna cook so healthy, and this vegan diet is gonna be so healthy. There are ways to make this unhealthy, okay? If I wanted to, I could just eat potatoes, aka fries, every day, and it would be vegan. But I think the part of this that is good is finding creative ways to eat vegetables, right? That's starting to taste really good. Okay, I'm gonna let this simmer.
good. Not real good.
Back to our seasoned meat. We got the, except it's not meat.
Back to our seasoned not meat. Y'all, guess what I'm seasoning my tofu with? Am I predictable or what? Sazon, honey, sazon. Because I'm Mexican and Puerto Rican. And sazon is a part, look at just how good it looks. Let me bless y'all with this view. Sazon is just, it's just the real deal. It makes everything taste better. There's never been a time I put sazon in something and it hasn't made it better. There's never been a time. Uh-oh, I only got 2 packets left in here. Never been a time this hasn't elevated the... Now, I don't know if this is good for you. I just want to make that clear. It says glutamato, sal, ajo, amarillo cinco. Yeah, there's some stuff in here, y'all. But is it bad that I just know it's so good? This is what it's gonna take for me to stay on this diet for now. It's Mixio. Oh yeah, honey. Mm-hmm. I hope that you are filled. I wish you could smell it. Filled with flavor. Okay, food, I'm talking to you, okay? I know I'm like newly vegan, but I hope that as you bake, you take on a similar texture as chicken, okay? But if you don't, it's okay. I hope you at least soak up this flavor. Okay, I'm gonna put this on the pan. I hope you soak up the flavor, honey. We know there's some dyes in there because these hands, they're not as red as hot Cheetos, but yeah, we know there's not some good stuff in there like dye orange 5. It's okay, it's okay. Wow. Wowza. Hey, let me go ahead and put some olive oil on this fake chicken over here. I'm like, should I toast? Can I cook veggies with this? Do they cook at different temps? That's a really good idea. You should have thought sooner, baby girl. You know what? If I want veggies, I'll stick them on another pan. I'm gonna test this out solo. Going in the oven. Let's check on our green, red curry. I keep saying green curry. Listen, I tried to make green curry one day and it was not unsavable. It just didn't go well, y'all. Oh, okay. Something to note. Oh, this is an air fryer that I had left it alone and the tofu that was at the bottom got a little crispy like meat. I don't mind it. I actually don't mind it. Oh, let me show you. Don't judge the mess back here, okay? I don't need y'all judging me. Well, that's it, y'all. This is the meal for, I don't know what day this is, 16, 17? I don't even know. I'm starting to crave like unhealthy foods. Today, sorry, I had a celebration. Anytime I think of something negative, I gotta celebrate. I gotta do something positive too. You know, beat it. Today, my friends, today, I found a vegan muffin at a coffee shop. It was made with cranberries and orange. I don't think I put cranberries in my muffins, But it was still very tasty. It was very moist. It was very good. And, oh, I'm turning off that heat. First of all, whatever y'all did right now, well, you just cooked. It's like the flavors came out. The spice came out. Yes, honey, as you simmered. You're delicious as you simmered. You're turning out all right. I'm gonna make some type of grain with this because what I've noticed is that when I don't eat some type of grain with the food I'm eating, I feel hungry still. Can anybody relate? So I'm gonna add some grain to this. So I have a little bit of quinoa left. That's what I think I'm gonna make. I'll top this over quinoa. I also have some white rice or jasmine rice, but I prefer the quinoa today. Do you know that quinoa is pretty high in protein? If you didn't know, now you know. I totally forgot what I was talking about. Oh, my muffin. So yeah, today I had 2 coffee meetings and I did do 2 options. I did a vegan toast. I did an avocado toast, which is totally vegan. I had to request it without the egg because I normally top it with egg. I did my latte with oat milk. And then I also ordered later on at the next coffee shop, this vegan muffin and a chai. It was very good. And that's it. I love you all. I hope you're having an incredible day. And I hope that this video continue to push the perspective of trying new foods and going vegan. Toodles. Oh my goodness. See how orange that is? Toodles. Sazon style. Peace.